as I had suspected, there had been a real push to eliminate the major third among most major composers. The only people who were really championing the major third were bubblegum composers and me. I met, I think this is the guy's name, I could be confusing him with another guy. And I think his name's Reed Whitelaw. He wrote Yummy, 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 I've Got Love in My Heart. I met him, but I didn't hurt him. I had this tune stuck in my head once, and I asked David Lindley how to get it out, and he said, sing it backwards, it'll be out of phase with itself, and it'll cancel. It's in your head now, so remember that. So that's where these guys like Stockhausen come from, you know, they just didn't want to hear any more yummy tummies and thirds. And they have one, there is a good argument for it, which is that the third is indeterminate. You can't really figure where its pitch is, and that drives some people, especially composers, nuts. Well, suffer, that's what I say. There's something really charming about it. Granted, it can be overdone. I mean, take any Christmas record. Well, not anyone, but yeah, take any. Why should I? So this tune exploits it shamelessly. I cannot resist playing it every night. It was written for a wedding, which figures, by Eddie Reeves and Alex Harvey. Alex had several hits of his own, and Eddie Reeves was the A&R guy for, I think, RCA Nashville. And two friends of theirs were getting married, and they asked, would they write a song? And then they said, yes. And then they said, would you play it at the wedding? And they said, yeah, because they knew what was going to happen. Everybody knew. This couple would have very public fights, break up, and then for some reason get back together again. And they, you know, they thought, gee, we keep getting back together, why don't we get married? Everyone else thought, you keep blowing up, why don't you stay away from each other? Two guys had to pretend everything was fine and this was a great idea and it was going to be beautiful. And they wrote this song for it. It helps to have that undercurrent if you have sour, if you happen to have any antipathy toward the major third. This will help you out a lot. The marriage ended in a wedding, and the wedding ended about 3 years later. Squeeze it harder. Talking to Tony and Mario. sun comes up across the city, and I swear you never looked so young and pretty. Hand in hand we'll stand upon the sand with preacher man. Let the wedding bells ring.